Welcome to Watch and Wonder through Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles, and this behind-the-scenes feature on my Story Vignette oil painting, Webstrand's Moonlight Gathering, which can be seen in Chapter 3 of my illustrated fantasy folklore, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. I would very much like to introduce you to the two very different styles of painting to be found in Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, which is the second book in my Elphen Chronicles. The first is the masterwork paintings, and they are very large oil paintings. And when you discover them in Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, you will find that they are rectangular. In other words, the painting surface goes right to the edge of the rectangle, and they're contained with their own specifically designed frame. The vignettes, on the other hand, float on the page. Both styles of paintings fulfill quite a different purpose. The masterworks, the large oil paintings, are scene setters. In other words, they give you the overall view. But the vignettes are moments in time. They are, if you like, those unmissable flashes of visual ideas that I got as I wrote the book itself. And as such, really, they couldn't be left from the story, because they take you along with the words. They give that extra little bit of depth to the story itself. Both the masterworks and the vignettes are painted in oil, but you will find that they will give you a different insight into the book of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. This particular vignette is called Webstrand's Moonlight Gathering. Webstrand and Fizz have just met. It's after midnight in her bedroom. Webstrand has made a promise which she has to fulfill, and so she has had to summon her swarm, which are the group of elfin which you see all around her. They've just arrived through the starway, and they've peppered themselves all around Fizz's bedroom. They're on every surface that can be imagined. And so I wanted to show and give that feeling that Webstrand was surrounded by all of those elfin waiting to hear what she was going to say. And there she is, standing on the bottom of Fizz's bed, looking rather imperious and trying to explain herself to all her elfin friends. Three elfin were forced to scrabble from beneath its fall onto her bed below. At that, there followed a ripple of tiny giggles which swept across the whole bedroom. Despite language differences, it is obvious that laughter is universal. Grandly, Webstrand had taken a position on top of one of the brass bedposts at the bottom of Fizz's bed. She began to address the throng imperiously. "May I introduce you to our new friend Fizz?" Heads turned back to Fizz, and a rustle of muted whispers passed between the multitude. Fizz thought she might have caught the phrase "soft drink," but couldn't be sure. In spite of her strange nomenclature, perhaps not that strange being a human, she is to join us on our return home and then on to Arctura. A much more vigorous bout of whispering, accentuated with several loud gasps and exclamations of surprise, rippled around the assembly. The particular technique used for all of the vignettes is both traditional and quite unique and new, and I know that sounds a contradiction in terms, but line and wash has been used for generations in watercolour. Here, it's used in oil paint. Let me explain exactly how these layers of oil paint work. First of all, I created the image in my sketchbook to work out the composition. And I really wanted this idea of Webstrand being encircled by all her friends. So the balance of the composition itself, where everything fell, was incredibly important. Even to the fact that one of the Elphen, right in the foreground, her wings actually come out of the vignette. I wanted you to feel that you could move into this space. And it was moving towards you too. Once I'd got the composition right in my sketchbook, I transferred it onto the surface. Now this surface, unusually, was going to be an oil painting surface, so it had to be resistant to the oil paint itself. So although I worked on a paper surface, the paper itself was first fixed down to a more stable surface, and then it was given layers of ground which made it impervious to the oil paint itself. Once that surface had dried and was ready to work on, I created the line work. And the line work itself was created with an acrylic ink. This was applied over the surface with a brush. A brush being incredibly important, ink line can be applied with pen or anything you want, something, you know, something which will give a line. But a brush is particularly responsive to the hand. It can move from a very, very fine detail to quite a thick, fluid, solid state as it moves around the composition. And it can really describe the surface in its own right before any colour is added. After that, a layer of colour was added. Now this colour is quite unique in its own right because the colour responded first of all to the subject, which was the moonlit night, the feeling of the ghostly light that was coming through the window. But it also relates to the chapter itself. If you check out the other vignettes within this particular part of the book, you will find that they all have this underlying colour, this underlying gentle grade purple. And it also links up, because of Sunita's design, with the book pages, so that it nestled within the page itself. So that layer was important, although you will have to search for it to see it. Once you start seeing it, you will see how that colour changes in every chapter of the book. The next stage of the painting was to apply a tonal layer. This was a series of shades of black, or grey if you like, which create the light within the painting, create volume, depth and light. It spills the light across the figures from the window and shows the transparency of the wings. Once that had been achieved, I could then apply the colour. Now this is really the unique layer, very much the unique layer of the painting, because I've always loved layers of glaze in oil. The wonderful thing about the glazes of oil is that as you put them on, they stay exactly the same as you apply them. They don't change in any way. So the colour can be controlled no matter how many layers are applied, but these layers are transparent. They allow the tonal work beneath to come through. So the volume and light has been achieved, the colour can be applied, and that can be rich and deep and give all of that elfin magic which was required for these particular paintings. We all live in a world of skepticism, disbelief, and doubt. But imagine, if you will, one filled with mystery and magic. Here, wishes can actually come true in a way you would hardly believe. Let me share with you the chronicle of an earthling who goes by the nickname Fizz, whose creative imagination and zest for life leads her on a remarkable journey. A journey which was to change her life forever, on which her guide was none other than Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Watch as I depict the story of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Through my scene setting, original Masterworks oil paintings. And the many storytelling illustrations that capture this epic tale. And listen as this chronicle of a wondrous journey is told. Well spotted, Fizz, Webstrand congratulated. Yes, it is an eye gem, but the flash doesn't develop until it's linked to its own special wearer. Owning an eye ring isn't just like wearing a piece of jewelry. It becomes the wearer's companion and can't be used by anyone else. And listen to the original musical soundtrack and soundscape that undulates through the good times and bad, the joy and horrors, the magical and real. If, like Fizz, you also come to believe in Elphen and search carefully along a star's path, you may find what appears to be a small glowing ember in the undergrowth. But be on your guard, for once you start the search, it can soon become a quest. Welcome to our artist's first edition video storybook, created, filmed, and produced by us in our own studio here in the Highlands of Scotland. We invite you to listen along with me as I personally read through my unabridged original story, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Available as a box set containing all 9 chapters for streaming here on Patreon. Accompanied not only by Liza's evocative music, which wends its way through the entire 9 chapters, but also by my 20 masterworks. And the 116 vignettes, which are brought to life as I read from the pages of this video storybook. In the telling of the wondrous journey and epic tale that is the Elphen folklore, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. This unique concept of our video storybook was inspired by the artistic interpretations of my original story and paintings by our fellow collaborators. Both Sunita, in her captivating book design, and our music director, Liza Mulholland, in her exclusive compositions, reflect the mood of the story as it unfolds from light beginnings through more challenging times. The swarm kept to the wing, swirling in colours all around her. She realised why. They were calling their farewells. But this was more than a call, it was a song. Although she understood not a word, its meanings were unmistakable. It was a song of friendship, of things done together, and of things yet to come. Faster moved the kaleidoscope of colourful wing, and then, on a rush of air, the swarm re-entered the corridor as one. And was gone. Time seemed to retrace its steps. Here was the same Fizz as before. Well, perhaps a little changed. Sitting on our bed, in the gloom of the same night on which they had left.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome to my studio in the Highlands of Scotland, from where we bring you Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles. As a young child, I was a very solitary individual. I loved to play on my own, especially in my grandmother's garden. Part of the garden was cultivated, but the most of it was wild. And I loved walking through the long grasses and weeds and flowers that grew there. I remember those summer days, chasing butterflies and searching for insects and frogs under stones and logs. At the bottom of this garden, the very bottom of the garden, there was a small rise. And once I was beyond this small rise, I was hidden from my grandmother back in the house. Just at the bottom of the rise was a small area of different grasses. The large grasses diminished, and here was a swathe of fine green grass, and it grew in a perfect circle. And I remember one day, with the sun on my eyelids, as I sat on that rise, looking down on that grassy area, just closing my eyes for a moment and reopening them, there was a movement, and I recognized it as a blue butterfly. I know there are blue butterflies everywhere, but there weren't any in my grandmother's garden. I knew that because I'd chased many a butterfly. There were cabbage whites, there were tortoiseshells, red admirals, but I'd never seen a blue one there. So I was fascinated by it, but as I tried to focus my eyes on it, it disappeared. So I closed my eyes again and opened them just slightly, and the blue butterfly came back. And I thought this was incredibly strange. So I kept my eyes half closed, pretending I was asleep. And I watched this butterfly flutter around, and it was soon joined by another, and then another. And they began to fly in a circle, a clockwise circle around this green swathe of grass. You may say, well, you're probably asleep. I had, after all, closed my eyes. But this was not the only occasion it happened. After that time, I went down to that spot again and again throughout the summer, and the blue butterflies came back. And soon, I became absolutely entranced by their magic. As an adult, I always wanted to capture the essence of this magic, which is how, in the mid-90s, I found myself bringing to life the mysterious creatures that are the Elphen. During the light of day, I would take up my brush and watercolour paints to work on a set of 18 unique illustrations that were enchanting me. As I painted, I became so engrossed that all other paintings and books were forsaken in order to free my imagination and allow me to concentrate on completing my first book in the Elphen Chronicles, in which I recount a particular legend involving the Elphen swarm leader, Lacewing, and an itinerant artist by the name of Artemis Glynn. However, it had always been my hope to set aside enough time to work on a collection of oil paintings with which to depict another significant event in Elphen history. We invite you to join me as I share with you my latest illustrated book from Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Fast forward a few years later, and once more the lure of the Elphen was too great to resist. I began work on another unique collection of masterworks oil paintings. which were to take me well over 5 years to create. As before, the elfin folklore of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer took over my life as I worked on these all-important masterworks. The composition for each elfin portrait and scene-setting painting was originally based on my first draft of the narrative. Soon, however, I found myself changing the interpretation of the story within these paintings, as the world of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer took hold. Ultimately, the developing paintings had an ever-changing influence on the story. Until both my paintings and story reached a natural conclusion. But this was merely the completion of the first stage. We were now about to embark on the next exciting phase, for the book had to be designed. We had a million ideas to explore. Why not some dedicated elfin music? At the very least, the elfin song, which comes into the story. Our wish list was growing as we added special items. The studio was filling with examples of uniquely produced work by talented craftspeople. What if we filmed the work in progress to share online, so that people could peek behind the scenes at the various creative processes? And how about something else, which is a little bit different, something unique to us? A new concept, something that reflects the work we've been doing online for many years. An illustrated audiobook, maybe. What about something more than that? Welcome to our artist's first edition video storybook. We invite you to listen along with me as I personally read through my unabridged original story, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, available as a box set containing all 9 chapters for streaming on Patreon and Vimeo.